Here's another chest x-ray eye test. Do you see anything on this PA and lateral radiograph? I'm going to leave it up for 15 seconds. There's three major findings here. The first, and probably the most obvious, is that there's a nodule here in the right lung apex. What makes it a little bit harder is that the nodule is superimposed right over the clavicle. If you didn't see this nodule, remember that you should be comparing one side to the other side. And if you look over on the left, the apex is clear, whereas on the right, there's just too much opacity. There's two other important findings here, and I'm going to blow this up and give you another chance if you didn't see the other findings. One finding is that the right apical pleura is asymmetrically thickened. The margin of the pleura is right here. And on the left side, the pleura is nice and thin and pressed way up to the bone. So given that finding, I'd be concerned that this nodule has invaded the pleura. But there's one last important finding here. This is the left T1 transverse process and the left first rib. On the right, here's the T1 transverse process, but where's the rib? This is probably the hardest finding to make on this radiograph because you have to recognize that a normal structure is missing, and it's missing because the tumor has eroded through the bone. This is what's known as a Pancoast tumor, or tumor of the superior sulcus. These are the ones that cause Horner syndrome because of disruption of the sympathetic chain, which runs along the side of the vertebral bodies. Remember that Horner syndrome consists of ptosis, drooping of the eyelid, meiosis, a constricted pupil, and facial anhidrosis, or loss of sweating. So let's say that this is an approximately 2.5 centimeter tumor. What would be the T classification? Well, if we just went by size alone, that would make this a T1C. But since we know that it invades the chest wall, that bumps it up to a T3. If it also invaded any of the brachial plexus or spine, it would go to T4, which means that the stage of the tumor would be at a minimum a 2B. Let's take a look at the CT now. On lung windows, we can see the tumor. It was 2.7 centimeters in maximal dimension. On bone windows, we can see the asymmetry of the pleural thickening. On the left, the visceral and parietal pleura go all the way up to the bone, whereas on the right, we have thickening of the pleura. And then it's much easier to see the bone erosion on CT. On the left, we have the first rib here, and on the right, most of the medial part of the bone is eroded, and there's a pathologic fracture right here. All right, take home points for this case. Remember that the apices are a tough place for us because of the ribs and clavicle, so it's important to compare one side to the other to help detect an abnormality. And then second, if you do see an apical nodule, look for those additional findings of pleural thickening and rib destruction. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments.